Dear students, in this session we will discuss image and object space, so that the hidden part of an object could be seen by the viewers. In a picture containing non-transparent objects and surfaces, these surfaces cannot be seen, which falls behind the object. So, we may say that when we view a picture which have non-transparent objects and surfaces, then the viewer can't see those objects from view which is behind from objects closer to eye. So, while developing applications for graphics, it is required to remove these hidden surfaces to get a realistic screen image. The identification and removal of the surfaces is called hidden surface problem. So, to remove these problems, we have some methods. Most commonly, there are two methods for removing hidden surface problems. One is known as object space method, while the other one is image space method. The object space method is implemented in physical coordinate system, and the image space method is implemented in screen coordinate system. When we want to display a three-dimensional object on a two-dimensional screen, we need to identify those parts of a screen that are visible from a chosen viewing position. So, the method which we use are depth buffer, that is Z buffer method, which is an image space approach developed by Kutmal. In it, each surface is processed separately, one pixel position at a time across the surface. The depth values for a pixel are compared and closest surface determines the color to be displayed in the frame buffer. It is applied very efficiently on surface of polygon. Surfaces can be processed in any order. To override the closer polygons from the far ones, two buffers named frame buffer and depth buffer are used. The depth buffer is used to store depth value of for coordinate x and y, and surfaces are processed with depth falls between 0 and 1, whereas frame buffer is used to store the intensity value of color value at each pixel positions. The Z coordinates are usually normalized to the range at coordinate 0 and 1. The value 0 for Z coordinate indicates back clipping pan, and 1 value for Z coordinates indicate front clipping pan. So, in figure you are seeing that three different polygons are set to visualize all to the viewers. So it has so many advantages, like it is easy to implement. It reduces the speed problem if implemented in hardware. It processes one object at a time. That's why all can be visualized. But with a bigger disadvantage, like it requires large memory and also time consuming. So to do this is the algorithm in which buffer values of depth buffer and frame buffer are assigned. Afterwards, each polygon is processed to project its image one at a time. That computes the color coordinates of surface, and then its distance, I mean key depth buffer, is identified, which is clearly written in the algorithm. And based off the algorithm, a function is developed, and with the use of these functions, we ascertain the depth values. The another approach, that is area based approach. This approach was developed by Warnock. In this approach, each area are subdivided into four equal ways. At each stage in the recursive subdivision process, the position of each polygon has one of the four relationships to the area of interest. You are seeing on the screen that four figures A, B, C and D are appearing. The figure A, which is showing the image, is within the surrounding surface, whereas in B, the surface is overlapping partially inside and partially outside. And in figure C, the entire surface is inside the range. And in figure D, entire is completely is outside the range. So no further subdivision of a specified area are needed if one of the following conditions is true: all surfaces are outside surface with respect to the area, only one inside overlapping or surrounding surface is in the area, a surrounding surface obscures all other surfaces within the area boundaries. Warnock's algorithm, however, always subdivides the area to simplify the problem. After subdivision, only contained and intersecting surfaces need to be re-examined. So in the figure you are visualizing that the area is subdivided into a smaller segments. In this point, the algorithm has operated at object precision, with the exception of the actual scan conversion of the background and clipped surfaces in the four cases. These images, precision scan conversion operations, can be replaced by object precision operations that outputs a precise representation of the visible surfaces. Either a square of the area size, like case 1, 3 and 4, or a single polygon clipped to the area along with its Boolean component relative to the area representing the visible part of the background. So, now question arises, what about the cases that are not of these four? One approach is to stop subdividing when the resolution of the display at most 10 levels of subdivision are needed. If after this maximum number of subdivisions, none of the cases of 1 to 4 have occurred, then the depth of all relevant polygons is computed at the center of this pixel sized in divisible areas. The polygon with the closest z coordinate defines the shading of the area. Alternatively, for the purpose of anti-aliasing, several further levels of subdivision can be used to determine a pixel's color by weighing the color of each of its subpixel sized area by its size. These image precision operations performed when an area is not one of the simple cases that makes this an image precision approach. So, we have clearly understood here with the figure that the subdivision up to a precise level denotes that since up to the precise level the subdivision are done, that's why it is termed as precision approach. So, these are the two ways by which we define the image area space. There is a term coherence which we use while developing our graphic packages. So, coherence denotes the degree to which parts of an environment or its projection exhibit local similarities. Environments typically contain objects whose properties vary smoothly from one part to another. Various kinds of coherence have been identified, such as. So, the object coherence. This is a coherence in which one object is entirely separate from another. Comparison may need to be done only between the objects and not between their component faces or edges. The another one is face coherence, in which surface properties typically vary smoothly across a face, allowing computations for one part of a face to be modified incrementally to apply to adjacent parts. The next one is edge coherence, in which two edges are compared with one another. The next one is area coherence, in which a group of adjacent pixels is often covered by the same visible face. A special case of area coherence is span coherence, which refers to a face's visibility over a span of adjacent pixels on a scan line. The one that is known as implied edge coherence. If one planar faces penetrates another, their line of intersection, which is popularly known as implied edge, can be determined from two points of intersection. So, the next one is a scan line coherence. The set of visible objects spans determined for one scan line of an image typically differs little from the set of the previous line. The another one, that is depth coherence. Adjacent parts of the same surface are typically close in depth, whereas different surfaces at the same time on same screen location are typically separated far away in depth. Once the depth at one point of the surface is calculated, the depth point on the rest of the surface can often be determined by a simple difference equation. And the one more coherence, which is known as frame coherence. Here, pictures of the same environment at two successive points in time are likely to be quite similar despite a small changes in objects and viewpoint. Calculations made for one picture can be reused for the next in a sequence. So, these are various coherences upon which are used while developing the graphics applications. So, these are play a very key role in the development of applications. So, this is all about our today's session on image and object space. Okay, that's all.